Tom, I have news for you. I have spoken on your behalf to a good friend in the city, and he offers you a position in his counting house.
You are too generous, sir. You must not think me ungrateful if I do not immediately accept what you propose. But I have other prospects in view.
Your reluctance to seek steady employment makes me uneasy.
Be assured, your daughter shall not marry a poor man.
So he be honest, she may take a poor husband if she choose. But I am resolved she shall never marry a lazy one.
The old fool. Here I stand. My constitution sound. My frame not ill-favored, my wit ready, my heart light. I play the industrious apprentice in a copybook. I submit to the drudge's yoke. I slave through a lifetime to enrich others, and then be thrown away like a gnawed bone. Not I! Have not grave doctors assured us that good work books that have no avail, for heaven predestines all. In my fashion, I may profess myself of their party, and herewith entrust myself to fortune. Since it is not by merit we rise or we fall, but the favour of fortune that governs us all, that governs us all. Why should I labour for what in the end she will give me for nothing, if she be my friend? But you have found him straying in his thoughts and footsteps. In short...
You are here?
Yes, surely. Tom Rakewell at your service.
Well, well. Nick Shadow, sir. And at your service. For surely as you bear your name, I bear you a bright future. You recall an uncle, sir?
An uncle? My parents never mentioned one.
They quarreled, I believe, sir. Yet he... Sir, have you friends?
More than a friend. The daughter of this house and ruler of my heart.
A lover's fancy and a lovely thought. Then call her, call her. Indeed, let all who will make their joy hear of your glad tidings. Fair lady, gracious gentleman, a servant begs your pardon for your time, but there is much to tell. Tom Rakewell had an uncle, one long parted from his native land. Him I served many years, served him in the many trades he served in turn, and all to his profit. Yes, profit was perpetually his. It was indeed his family, his friend, his hour of amusement, his life. But all his brilliant progeny of gold could not caress him when he lay dying. Sick for his home, sick for a memory of pleasure or of love, his thoughts were but of England. There, at least, he felt his profit could be pleasure to an eager youth. For such, by counting years upon his fumbling fingers, he knew that you must be good, sir. Well, he is dead. And I am here with this commission to tell Tom Rakewell that an unloved and forgotten uncle, loved and remembered, you are a rich man. man.
I wished but once I knew that surely my wish would come true, that I had come to speak at last, and fate would smile when fortune cast the die. I knew, yet you bring the fateful end of questioning. Hereby, a new and grateful master side be thanked, and as my fortune and my guide, remain confirm
be thanked. Master, should I am I to long? I soon
be thanked.
Coachman, sir.
Should you not mind, I'll tell you of his needs.
Sir, you are kind.
Farewell, farewell, farewell for now.
me, good shadow. Since born and bred in indigence, I am unacquainted with such matters. What wages you are accustomed to receive?
Let us not speak of that, master, till you know better what my services are worth. A year and a day hence, we will settle our account. And then, I promise you, you shall pay me no more and no less than what you yourself acknowledge to be just.
A fair offer, 'tis agreed. Till for the true love, settled, I shall send for you and my dearest Anne. And when she arrives, all London shall be at her feet, for all London shall be mine, and what is mine must have needed. Oh, what I must with all my being worship.
Don't
I would fain have our hostess, good Mother Goose, learn how faithfully I have discharged my duties as a godfather in preparing you for the delights to which your newly found state of manhood is about to call you. So tell my lady bishop of the game what I did vow and promise in thy name.
One aim in all things to pursue, my duty to myself to do.
Is he not apt?
And handsome too.
What is thy duty to thyself?
To shut my ears to prudent preacher and follow nature as my teacher.
What is the secret nature knows?
What beauty is and where it grows?
Canst thou define the beautiful?
I can! That source of pleasure to the eyes, youth holds, wit snatches, money binds, envy affects so strong, but lies. One fatal flaw it has, it dies.
Exact, my scholar!
What is pleasure then?
The idol of all dreams, the same, whatever shame. Wear or name, whom flirts imagine as a hat, old maids believe to be a cat.
One final question. Love is...
Love, love, that precious word is like a fiery coal. It burns my nails, strikes terror to my soul.
No answer. Will my scholar fail me?
No, no more!
Well,
love.
Let me go!
Are you afraid?
Before it is too late.
Wait! Obey your pleasure, fear not, enjoy. You may repent at leisure. In the temple of delight, it is my privilege to present to you a stranger to our rites who, following our custom, begs leave to sing you a song in earnest of his desire to be initiated. As you see, he is young. As you shall discover, he is rich, my master, and if he will pardon the liberty, my friend, Mr. Tom Rakewell.
Thank you. Thank you. Tom has love no voice, can love not keep a maytime vow in cities, fades it as the rose cut for a rich display. Forgot, but no, to weep is not enough. He needs my help. Love heals, love knows, love answers him across the silent miles and goes.
Oh, Natural mother, how I have followed where you led. Is it for this I left the country? No ploughman is more a slave to sun, moon, and season than a gentleman to the clock of fashion. City, city. What Caesar could have imagined the curious viands I have tasted? They took me and lent a Porto and Provence keep all their precious wines. I would as soon be dry and wrinkled as a raisin as ever taste another. Cards, living pictures. And, dear God, the matrons with their marriageable girls cover their charms a little, you well-bred boards. Oh, your goods will touch the death of the room long before they learn of the green sickness. The others, too, with their more candid charms. Ha! Who's honest, chaste, or kind? Wish I were happy.
Master, are you alone?
And sick at heart, what is it?
Do you know this lady?
Baba the Turk.
I have not visited St. Giles' Fair as yet. They say that brave warriors who never flinched at the sound of musketry have swooned after a mere glimpse of her. Is such a thing possible in nature?
Two noted physicians have sworn that she is no impostor. Will you go see her?
Nick, I know that manner of yours. You have some skill, but come, sir, out with it.
Consider her picture.
Would you see me turn to stone?
Do you desire her?
Like the gout or the falling sickness.
Are you obliged to her?
Heaven forbid.
Then marry her.
Have you taken leave of your senses?
I was never saner.
Come, master, observe the host of mankind. How are they?
Wretched. Why? Because they are not free. Why? Because the giddy multitude are driven by the unpredictable mass of their pleasures, and the sober few are bound by the inflexible oath of their duty, between which favories there is nothing to choose.
Would you be happy?
Then learn to act freely.
Would you act freely?
Then learn to ignore those twin tyrants of appetite and
conscience.
Therefore, I counsel you, master, take Barbara the Turk to wife.
Consider her picture once more, and as you do so, reflect upon my words. In youth, the panting slave pursues the fair evasive day. Then caught in colder fetters, wounds wealth, office, or a name. Till old, dishonored, sick, downcast, and failing in his wits, in virtue's narrow cell, at last the withered bondsman sits.
Compel, nor reason can restrain. Well,
my tale shall be told both by young and by old, by young and by old, by young and by old.
Master, prepare your fate to dare.
A favorite narration throughout the nation, remembered by all in cottage hall, with song and laughter forever after.
Perfumed, well dressed, and looking your best, a bachelor of
fashion, I spent in fashion. Your carriage on, and upon your tongue, the gallant speeches that cupidity it is.
For tongues will not tire around the pile. Or sitting at me,
shadow to guide,
the tail to
come
the
come seek your bride,
cooking and wedding,
we have
the bedding
and doing,
of Barbara
the Turk,
that Barbara
the Turk, your charm,
the world,
would be as great as this Gorgon to mate,
or the world, the great land
of great world as well.
My heart, beat faster. Come, shadow.
Come, master. Come, master.
Thank you. even the purple dog they see. Food from dead fingers, living only. I tremble with no reason.
Ask me, accuse me.
Tom, no.
Denounce me to the world. And go, and go.
Tom, no.
Return, return to your home. Forget in your senses. What sense is in you?
Do you return?
I.
Then how shall I go?
You must.
It is done.
It's been with me.
Beautiful. Awake!
Who's there?
Your shadow master.
You! Oh, Nick, I've had the strangest dream. I thought, how could I know what I was never taught, or fancy optics I had never seen? I had devised a marvelous machine, an engine that converted stones to bread, where my old people's were for nothing fed. I saw polished by my skill, and earth become an heathen of goodwill.
Did your machine look anything like this?
I must be still asleep. That is my dream.
How does it work?
I need a stone.
Try this.
I place it here. I turn the wheel. And then...
certain
Extreme.
I know that I'm sorry, but who will give good money for this toy? Be sure. For
so it is. There's no fantastic lie. You cannot make men swallow if you try.
Omnipotent, well, I'm secular, and it is.
So you know your proper interest. Here is your code of transcendence. Come in, take your shares immediately, my friends. And raise the folly that pays these events.
Forgive me, master, for intruding upon your transports, but your dream is still a long way from fulfillment. Here is the machine, it is true, but it must be manufactured in great quantities. It must be advertised, it must be sold. We shall need money and advice, we shall need partners, merchants of probity and reputation in the city.
Alas, good shadow, your admonitions are only too just, and they chill my spirit. For who am I, who am become a byword for extravagance and folly, to approach such men? Is this dream too, this noble vision, to prove as empty as the rest? What shall I do?
Have no fear, master. Leave such matters to me. I have already spoken with several notable citizens concerning your invention, and they are as eager to see it as you to show.
Genius shadow, how could I live without you? I cannot wait. Let's visit them immediately.
Should you not tell the good news to your wife?
My wife! I have no wife! I've buried her!
Merchants are insane.
Wait,
assaulted, morning. spontaneous combustion, caught in hurry, he's dead.
Do you not speak of him?
Not of him, how should we?
He's Methodist, he's Methodist.
He's converted jewelry.
I'm sure you follow me, nay, plus ultra of auctions. Truly, there is a divine balance in nature. A thousand lose that a thousand may gain. And you, who are the fortunate, are not so only in yourselves, but also in being nature's missionaries. You are her instruments for the restoration of that order we all so worship, and it is granted to so few of us to serve. Let us proceed at once. Lots 1 and 2, which cover all objects subsumed under the categories animal, vegetable, and mineral. Who hears me knows me, knows me, a man with value. Look at this. What is it? Wit and profit. No one, no one could fail to conquer, fail to charm. Who had it by to watch? And who could not be a nimble planner? Having this, having this, having this before him. Bid, bid to get them, get them, get them high. Luck come bid, come by. The opportunity, lovely, wealthy. Poof, go high now, some more. Come on, the pike.
7. 7.
11. 11.
40. 40.
19. 19.
20. 23. Going at 23. Going, going, gone. Behold it, Roman moral, the man who has it forever, yes, and holy, holy, curing the body, soul, and spirit, a gift of God, a gift of God. And not to mention this or the other, more and more, and so help me, more. Then bid, oh get them, get them, get them, high. Luck come bid, come by.
4.
The past, feel life, turn. Poof, go high, luck some more. Come on, the palm.
50. 50.
And a half.
And a half.
3 quarters.
3 quarters.
60. 60.
70.
17.
Going at 17. Going, going, gone. Wonderful. Yes, yes.
And now for the truly adventurous. An unknown object draws us near. A cake, an organ, golden apple tree, a block of copal, mint of alchemy, oracle, pillar, octopus, we'll see. Be brave, perhaps an angel will appear. Come be, come by, the it, this may be salvation. Go high, become, come on, the world.
his poisoned victim, and who snake? Then come, but where shall you, my dear, a gifted lady, never need a fear? I shall go back and grace the stage where man rules and wealth attends. Can I deny my time is late, my self-indulgent
you my soul with fear.
A year and the day have passed away since first to you I came. All things you bid I duly did, and now my wage is claim.
A bit upon our friendship, but Nick, as you know, is a gentleman at heart, forgives your dilatoriness and suggests a game.
A game?
A game of chance to finally decide your fate. Have you a pack of cards?
All that remains me of this world and for the next.
You jest. Fine, fine. Good spirits make a game go well. I shall explain. The rules are simple, and the outcome simpler still. Nick will cut three cards. If you can name them, you are free. If not, you choose the path to follow me. You understand? Let us begin. Well, then.
My heart is wild with fear. My throat is dry.
Come.
I cannot see.
wish be thought and think on one to name. You wishing on your fear could rule the game instead of shadow. Of hearts. You see, it's quite a simple game.
To win at once in love or cards is dull. The gentleman loves sport, for sport is rare. The positive appalls him. He plays the pence of hope to yield the guineas of despair.
Again, good Tom, you are my master yet.
What shall I trust in now? How throw the door?
Come, try. Fortune not your mistress once, be fair. Give her at least the second chance to bear the hand of shadow.
The deuce!
She lights the shades and shows the two of spades.
The two of spades. Congratulations, the goddess still is faithful. But you have one more, you know, the very last. Think for a while, my Tom, where you have come to. I would not want your last of chances thoughtless. I am, you may have oftentimes observed, really compassionate. Think on your hopes.
Oh God, what hopes are
the sin? The trick, the simpler the deceit, that there is no return. I've taught him well, and repetition follows him. The queen of hearts again shall be for him the queen of hell.
Rouse yourself, Tom. Travail soon will end. Come, try.
Now in this world,
he'll find no aid, and fortune. Tom, come, try.
Dear God, a track of cloven hooves.
The knavish goats are back to crop the spring's return.
Return and love the band.
You cannot now repent.
Return, return, O love.
Thank you. I wish for nothing else.
Thank you.
she gave me her promise
that this cancels every vow she will never keep it.
Come out quickly, Venus, or I die.
Labyrinth, Sing, Achilles? Helen! Eurydice! Orpheus! Persephone! All my tortures! Hola! Where is my Venus? Why have you stolen her while I slept? Madman! Where have you hidden her?
I
many insist I will not exist. At times I wish I didn't.
So let us sing as one.